SAFIRE Project is a scientific endeavor to explore the electric universe hypothesis. The idea that the sun is a positively charged body in a negatively charged environment. That's fundamentally the premise that the electric universe is built on. If you break it right down, it's based on the principle of charged plasma affecting matter of a different electrical potential. And it was based on that that I had done a number of evaluations of the electric universe model. I wouldn't say it's at this point in time a mature hypothesis where it's mathematically defined. And even if it is mathematically defined, like so many other models, there's a lot of assumptions in the physics and the math that you have to shake out to see whether or not there's substance to it. The electric universe model is simpler in its construct than the conventional model, which is based on gravity. There are a number of theories with respect to various phenomena or characteristics that we see with the sun, whether it's a theory of how sunspots come into being or the photosphere or the temperature of the corona. Each one, when you dig into it, has its own hypothesis or theory as to how those characteristics come into being due to one cause, which is gravity. And there are a lot of disparities with it. It's a challenge for modern heliophysicists or solar physicists to bring this model into an understanding where you can place gravity at the heart of all of these and mechanisms and processes by which these will all occur due to gravity. We have an objective to see if we can recreate the sun in a chamber. Some people call it a star in a jar. Some people call it a sun in a box. It's built on the electric universe model, and the idea is that the sun is a positively charged body in a negatively charged environment. And that's what we're attempting to do. That is the research objectives with SAFIRE. Well, it started off with research that I was doing on my own. A partner and myself had developed some technology for the solar industry, and we submitted it for a patent. I mentioned to him I was going to do further research into the sun and the potential of obtaining energy in ways that were efficient. And I had come across a video from the electric universe with respect to the sun, and I had run into a number of disparities with the conventional model, one of them being gamma rays. The sun itself doesn't really emit that many gamma rays, which I personally had a problem with, considering it's supposed to be this nuclear furnace, a byproduct of those kinds of reactions. So I contacted Walt Thornhill and sent him my CV because I was doing research into this and I wanted him to take me seriously. So that's when David Talbot contacted me. Walt didn't contact me initially. And David asked me if I could help the electric universe. And I had mentioned back to him, I was really contacting Walt based on the research that I was doing. And David convinced me that I could help in some way and sent me a pile of information on the electric universe. And I started conversations with Walt and got to know better what the electric universe model was based on. And at that point, I was asked to do an evaluation, and I did. But I didn't base it on plasma physics, base it on statistical model to evaluate whether or not the process by which the electric universe model of a positively charged sun in a negatively charged environment could stand. And took a look at a number of documents associated with stellar luminosity, the temperature, a number of characteristics of stars, and determined that, in fact, it made a lot of sense that it could be a simple process that can light up the billions of stars that we see. And then further went into research to see if there was any precedent, if there was any other experiments that had been done in the past. And there was, dating back as far as Crookes, Birkeland, Quinn, Schmidt, Fioretto. I was doing a feasibility study to determine if an experiment might be conducted to test the electric universe hypothesis. And as it turned out, it is feasible to test this principle. And so I did a number of other talks, a couple of them in Albuquerque, one in Phoenix, one in Las Vegas, another one at the University of Maryland, and met at Johns Hopkins University, and worked on developing what the experiment might look like. And I was approached by a man by the name of Scott Mainwaring, who said he wanted to fund it. And I told Scott, before we spend a lot of money, let's just shake it out and see if we can even do this. The intent was not to just create a light show, but bring to bear modern technology where we can obtain really good data to diagnose the plasma that we would hope to get. So we started off with phase one, a proof of concept, and the results were astounding. We did not expect to get some of the behavior that we had gotten. It looks like a sun. It behaves a lot like a sun. We had limited the power to 1800 watts DC, and there were times when the atmosphere developed its own spherical stratified atmospheres around the core. And the energy built up in these atmospheres to such an extent that it blew off into the chamber. And when it did, it surged with a release of power over 10 million watts at times. And we were shocked. We did not expect that kind of behavior. We were watching this dense cloud of ions build up just off the surface of the anode. And just to digress for a minute, right now we're just estimating. We believe the plasma is around 2,000 to 3,000 degrees. And that's way beyond the melting temperature of the core itself. But the core, we believe right now, is maybe 600 degrees Celsius, which in itself is a very interesting phenomenon. If you study thermodynamics, you would expect that there would be, you know, the gas would be extremely hot, that the anode, the core itself, would be extremely hot, and then the heat would dissipate outward. But we didn't find that at all. What we found is that it built up a cloud of ions just off the surface, maybe about a millimeter or so. The anode was cooler. The plasma was maybe, like as I said, 2,000 to 3,000 degrees, we're estimating. But it got very dense. And when it got dense, that's when it blew off into the chamber. We've submitted one paper on this, on the study of striations. Those ions are trapped in the stratified layer. We call them striations. And we believe that that may be occurring with the photosphere in the sun. Now, further to that, we did measure the temperatures. We have fairly good spectral equipment to measure the energy states of the ions. And what we found, to our surprise again, is that we had higher energy states the further out that we went. In other words, the gas is hotter, or the temperature is hotter, in the same way that we see a higher coronal temperature than we do with the photosphere. It looks like a sun, it acts like a sun, and other characteristics of it appear to be a direct correlation to what we see with the sun.